right. It's so good to see you. Wait, are you out there? I can't see you, but you can see me. And we're so glad that you decided to join us today. And we have an awesome lesson for you. And let me tell you, you've probably heard a little bit about this before, maybe at home and at school. It's about your attitude. But before we get started, I need you to get up off your seat, stand up, and we are going to do our pledges. So let's stand and put your hand over our heart, and we're going to say the pledge to the American flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now to the Christian flag. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life and liberty to all who believe. All right, so our PowerPoint today is talking about I am blessed when I have a good attitude. You know, I've been kind of told this before from my parents, and I think it's something that's been spread on, and I share it with my kids. It says, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. Like, for instance, I might ask my kids, like, let's just say Owen. He's an easy target. Owen, go pick up your room. Okay, Mom, I'll pick up my room. And he's obedient, and he does it, but he's got this scrunchy little face, and he's, you know, he's frowning, and I'll say, you know, it's not what you say, it's how you say it, even though he was obedient. And you know what? That good attitude is going to be so important in your life. Not just about cleaning your room. This is not what this is about. But what it is, it's about relationships. Because when you have a good attitude with your friends, that good attitude is going to help you with your family. That good attitude is going to propel you in the activities at school, your jobs, employment, your success in life is really connected to your attitude. And so tonight you want to listen closely to about how we can have that good attitude. And it's God that gives us that. He gives us that heart and a good attitude. So before we get started in our lesson, let's go ahead and pray together. Lord Jesus, thank you so much for your love and your goodness. We ask that you come in your presence, come into this lesson today. I pray for every person that watches this video to have an open heart, to help them to listen and be willing to obey you in all that you do. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name.
Hello, Kids Church. It's time to sing our praises to the Lord. And that's what we're going to do with the first song. We're going to worship Him. And it says, worship Him forever. Lord, we want to praise you. We want to lift you up, and we want to give everything we have to you. So stand up, boys and girls, and let's sing worship you forever.
I will worship you forever.
second song is Every Day, and that's Who I Live For. Everything I do, you're who I live for.
Like to say that it's you. You gave me life and I can't explain just how much you mean to me now. That you will say, Lord, you're all that I am to you. That every day I could do. Every day, Lord, I bring a step on your way, and I pray that I might close it for you, Lord, that you would guide me in every single step I take in. Every day, I can be a light to the world. Every day, it's you I live for. Every day, I'm
goes like this. I am a C, I am a CH, and what does that spell? That spells Christian, and that's how I need to be each and every day. Hit it, Sister Mallory.
I will live for you. right. So tonight's memory verse is a very simple one. It's a good verse. All verses are good, but this is an especially good verse because it tells us something very important. It tells us how God blesses us. And so we're going to read it, or I'll read it a couple times and we'll say it, and then hopefully I can explain it to you. So this is how it goes. God blesses those people who want to obey him. Matthew 5:6. We're going to say it again. God blesses those people who want to obey him. Matthew 5:6. All right, last time. Here we go. God blesses those people who want to obey him. Matthew 5:6. Now, I have a friend up here to help me today. This is Sister Zipporah. She is going to read some verses about the blessings of God and what that means. So go ahead, sister.
Even by the God of thy Father, who shall help thee, and by the Almighty, who shall bless thee with blessings of heaven above and blessings of the deep that lieth under. Genesis 49:25. And ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy water, and I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. Exodus 23:25. Wherefore it shall come to pass, if you hearken to these judgments and keep and do them, that the Lord thy God shall keep unto thee the covenant and the mercy which he sware unto thy fathers. Deuteronomy 7:12.
So God promises to bless us with good things. Things like children, food, water, the things that we need. That's what God will bless us with. But he's given us a stipulation, or he's given us something that we have to do. And the Bible tells us that when we follow his judgments, then he will do it. And what's interesting, what he says about in this verse is he said, he doesn't just bless people who obey him. That'd be great. But in today's lesson, we're learning about your attitude. And in this particular verse, it says, he blesses those who want to obey him. Now, that really affects your attitude, because I can obey you, like Sister Rebecca said, I can obey, but I don't always obey with a good spirit or with a good attitude. And when I want to do it, it's the desire of my heart. My heart reaches out. God, what is it that you want me to do? I want to follow you. And God blesses that. He loves that about you when you want to obey him. So one more time, we're going to say this, and then I will move on. God blesses those people who want to obey him. Matthew 5:6. All right.
Hey guys, it's Brother Kurt with your Bible lesson tonight. And it's a great lesson on how you can be blessed. How many of you would want to be blessed in your life? I know you've heard in your scripture memory verse what it blessed, being blessed actually means. But if you want to be blessed, you need to do what God asks you to do. And our Bible lesson comes from Matthew chapter 5 tonight. It's called the Sermon on the Mount. The reason it's called that is because Jesus was talking to a large group of people that had followed him, and he went up to the side of a mountain to tell them what it takes to be blessed. So tonight we're going to watch a short video, then we're going to come back and talk about it a little bit, but I want you to listen closely as Jesus tells us what it takes for us to be blessed.
God's story, the Sermon on the Mount. So part of God's story is about a sermon Jesus gave on the side of a mountain and what he did afterwards. And it goes like this. One day, when Jesus saw crowds gathering to hear him teach or see him do miracles, he went to the side of a mountain. It was near the Sea of Galilee, across from a place called Capernaum. From there, he gave a message all about God's kingdom and his love. We call this message the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus started by explaining who would get blessings or favor from God. He said the most blessed people are those who are poor, sad, or humble. He said God shows favor to people who are just or treat others fairly, and people who are merciful or show love to those who don't deserve it. He said the people who are pure, who bring peace, or who get hurt for doing right will be rewarded for their actions in heaven. In other words, the people who love others, even when it makes them seem weak or unimportant on earth, are like heroes in God's kingdom. Anyway, Jesus went on to explain that when we believe in and follow him, it's our job to show everyone else who he is by loving them. That means going out of our way not only to comfort and help our friends, but also forgive people who hurt us, love our enemies, and give to people in need. The thing is, Jesus didn't just talk about love, he showed it all the time. In fact, right after giving this sermon, Jesus spent the rest of the day helping everyone he met. First, as Jesus came down from the mountain, a man with a skin disease called leprosy knelt before him. "Lord," the man said, "if you are willing, you can heal me and make me clean." Usually, no one wanted to be around people with leprosy, but Jesus touched him and said, "I am willing. Be healed." Instantly, the leprosy disappeared. Then, when Jesus arrived in Capernaum a bit later, a soldier said to him, "Lord, my servant is in terrible pain." Right away, Jesus said, "I will come and heal him." The officer said, "Just say the word from where you are, and my servant will be healed." Jesus told him, "Because you believed, it has happened." The officer's servant was healed. A little later, Jesus arrived at his disciple Peter's house. Peter's mother-in-law was there too, sick in bed with a high fever. Jesus touched her hand, and the fever left. Later that evening, many other people who were demon-possessed or sick came to see Jesus. He brought relief to all of them. At the end of the day, Jesus got into a boat with his disciples. Suddenly, a fierce storm came out of nowhere. Waves began crashing into the boat. The disciples realized that even though they were in the middle of a giant storm, Jesus was fast asleep. They shouted, "Lord, save us! We're going to drown!" Jesus said, "You of little faith, why are you so afraid?" Then he told the wind and waves to stop. They did. That day, Jesus taught a lot of people how to love and showed them what love looks like. Whenever somebody took their sickness or pain or fear to Jesus, he helped them. Everybody who met Jesus got to experience his love. And when we love like Jesus, everyone who meets us can feel his love too. And that's the story of the Sermon on the Mount. So, in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Crowds gathered. Jesus went to a mountain. He gave a sermon. He talked about God's kingdom. He told us how to love others. Jesus didn't just talk about love. He showed it. He healed sick people. He saved people who were demon-possessed. He calmed storms. He showed his love to everyone he met. Our job is to do that too. And that's a part of God's story.
I hope you enjoyed the Bible video tonight. These are called the Beatitudes. When Jesus said, blessed is, you know what? These are found in Matthew chapter 5. And we're going to review a few of these tonight. And Jesus is telling us how to have a blessed life. You know, you may wonder, how can I be blessed? Well, Jesus told the people on the Sermon on the Mount, this is how you can be blessed. And let's just review a few of these tonight. It says, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. You know what? These are just a few of the Beatitudes, a few of the scriptures that Jesus said are blessed. But, you know, there's one common thing that you can be found in all these. You know, it says, blessed are the meek. You know, if you're meek, usually you have a good attitude, don't you? You know, you think, oh, I've heard that word tonight, a good attitude. Blessed are those, I am blessed when I have a good attitude. Well, you know what? Most people who are meek, usually that comes with having a good attitude. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. You know, when someone does something bad to you and you forgive them and you have mercy upon them, usually that shows your attitude. Usually that means you have a good attitude. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. You know, blessed are those who, if you have a pure heart, that usually means your attitude is good. It is right. If your heart's pure, the rest of you is going to be pure. And that means you're having a good attitude. So you see tonight, you know, our PowerPoint tonight is, I am blessed when I have a good attitude. If you want to be blessed in life, you know, it's not, you looked at that common thread is through all these these scriptures. You are blessed by having a good attitude. So this week, I want you to just say in your own mind, say, you know what, God? I'm going to do the best I can to have a good attitude because I want to please you and I want to be blessed. We'll see you next week.
In these hands and multiply, God, all that I am, and find my heart on the altar again. Set me on fire, set me on fire.
Come on, say,
take all I have in these hands and multiply, God. All that I am, and find my heart on the altar again. Set me on fire.
Ask him.
Set me on fire. Here I am, God, arms wide open, pouring out my life. Gracefully broken. My heart stands in awe of your name. Your mighty love stands strong to the end. You will fulfill your listen to me, you won't forsake. You will be with me.
You will be with me.
Here I am, God, say, arms wide open.
Oh, pouring out my love,
pouring out my life. I'm holding nothing back. Holding nothing back.
I surrender.
I surrender.
You ought to throw your hands up and say, I surrender.
I surrender.
Say, I surrender.
I surrender.
All that I am, I surrender.
I surrender.
God, arms wide open. I'm right here, pouring out my life, gracefully broken.
Hallelujah, Lord. Jesus, we want to live for you. We love you, Lord. Jesus' name, Jesus' name.
Hey kids, how many of you have ever heard someone say that they want to get in shape? And maybe you've even tried to get in better shape. Sometimes people will go to the gym or they'll lift weights, kind of like these dumbbells. Maybe they'll run, just different things. And sometimes when you first start working a muscle, like maybe you're working your biceps or something, it kind of hurts because you're stretching those muscles. But then when you stretch them out, they grow and you get stronger. So there's another thing that we really need to work on, and we exercise that by practicing, and that is our attitude. Sometimes to have a good attitude at first, it kind of hurts. And it's already been mentioned today, but when our mom tells us to go clean our room and we keep a smile on our face and we go do it, but we really don't want it kind of hurts because we really don't want to do that. But the more we practice having a good attitude, the easier it gets. And before we know it, it's just so easy to have a good attitude all the time and smile, keep a smile on our face. So the more we practice, the better we get at it. And we are blessed when we have a good attitude.
Hello, everybody. It's so important. We've talked about it all night long or all day long. No matter when you're listening to this, it applies. Because there is something to be said about the way we approach things. Now, when the Lord comes into our life, He puts a light in each one of us. I'm going to put down this mic just for a second. And He lights up our life. And the Lord wants us to be happy. But sometimes, it's like Sister Rebecca said, we can do the right thing, but we can be unhappy about it. We can have a bad attitude. The Lord can say, I want you to talk to your friend at school. I want you to do this for me. And we can say, okay. And that's what happened. It blows out the joy. Yes, we're doing it, but it looks like it's real painful. And nobody, who would want to listen to me with a face like that? They would say, I definitely don't want what you're selling. Well, the Lord doesn't want it to be that way. He wants us to be able to do things with a cheerful and good attitude. And that changes everything. Do you know that when you... It's proven with research that even if you feel badly, if you just go through and do like this, even though you feel terrible inside, eventually you start feeling better. But it's way more than that when Jesus gives us what we need. He helps us. He blesses us when we have a good attitude. When you begin to pray and you ask the Lord to help you with the situation and you tell the Lord, Lord, this really scares me, and I'm afraid I'm going to sound really silly, and I'm afraid I won't do it right, and all of these things just cloud our minds. Those attitudes can, like I said before, they can, but when Jesus is in your heart, it just flames back up, and He says, I'm going to be with you. You can do this, and you may have people around you that say, I don't even know why you're trying to do that. They try to blow it out in your life. And they try to say, that's not going to work. It won't happen. But Jesus says, oh, yes, it will. Because if I'm for you, who can be against you? I'm telling you that when you turn it over to Jesus and you let His light shine in your heart and you stay in a frame of mind that says, Lord, I don't know what I can do, but I know what you can do. And you keep that positive attitude. The Lord will keep that burning in your life and your heart. You know what? I'm so glad all of you were here tonight, today, whenever you're watching this. And we're going to pray right now.
And we're going to ask the Lord to put that kind of light in your life, that no matter what circumstances try to put it out, no matter what people say, that you will understand that He is greater than anything in your life, and He's going to help you. Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, I pray, Lord, that the light that's in every one of these students' lives will just continue to flame for You. And Lord Jesus, that they will walk in the path that You've called them to do. It doesn't matter if it's being obedient to their parents, obeying You, doing things, Lord, that they know are pleasing to You, and just being an example to those around them. I pray that You will help them to do it with the joy of the Lord, and You will just continue to keep that burning in their hearts. And we thank You and praise You for this day that You have given to us. This is the day that You've made, and we rejoice in it. In Jesus' name. And we want you to come back next week and see that light's just going to keep burning through the week. All right, you guys have a great week. The end.